Hey, good morning, everyone. Brian Hoops with Midwest Market Solutions. This is Market Insider TV, our opening commentary, Friday, November the 3rd. Thanks for joining us here this morning as we take a look at our trading day ahead. All right, non-farm payrolls out this morning, unemployment rate out this morning, 3.9% unemployment. That's up from 3.8 last month, and that was expected in non-farm payrolls. 150,000 versus the 180,000 that was expected. So let's look at the stock market here first and its reaction and crude oil's reaction. We can see we've had big rise here in the stock market last 3 days, bouncing off of this long-term support. And we're up again here this morning overnight. This news is being taken friendly as the stock market here. Bond prices are dropping, and it's almost like the bonds are anticipating Fed's going to lower rates, which we really don't expect that to happen until sometime in 2024. But at least a pause in the rates has given us a rise, a sharp rise in the stock market. Crude oil also reacting positively. We bounced off a long-term support yesterday, seeing a bounce today. Now we've taken out quite a bit of resistance in here. See if we can close above that with your next major resistance up to 85.32. The dollar, as you can imagine, is falling, kind of in a weak market, weak time period in here after this news this morning. So we're down into some long-term support in here. In fact, we gapped lower yesterday, and this is potentially bullish for commodities if this dollar can break. You can see we're sitting on long-term support, and that has rallied gold and silver quite a bit. Silver's up today 20 or 45 points, and the gold charts were getting back to those old highs that we had just a week ago. This gold market's come a long ways off of its lows, this gap, breakaway gap here, and continue to build on that as we go forward here. Now let's look at the grains as they were trading overnight and what we can expect today. Notice corn has broken below support, traded below it yesterday. The lows here were 467 and three quarters. The low in the overnight, 468. There is not much news for the corn market, but we broke through this. Back here, we closed back above it the next day, and then that kind of set off a rally. It's important today that we close back above this resistance. Of close below it, and more technical selling is going to take place, in my opinion. And this comes with a lower dollar as well. Now, the soybeans are bouncing and rallying. We're almost breaking out above resistance in here. Concerns about South American weather, especially in that northern part of Brazil, of course, southern Brazil and parts of Argentina getting too much rain and flooding in some areas. So we're seeing a big breakout on the soybean charts. We've been recommending to have re-ownership of soybeans, not so much corn because there isn't that bull market. We have that big balance sheet to worry about, but soybeans is the one to be long. And wheat, we're coming off of contract lows. There's really not much exciting here for the wheat. Wheat doesn't have much of a story as far as exports go. The winter wheat crop is off to a pretty good start. So get a rally back up in this 659 area is might be the best we can do for Kansas City. That's about 15-cent rise unless corn and wheat find some fun short covering along with the soybeans. Soybeans are going to have to drag the markets higher here. Cattle had a good day yesterday, and pull up a chart. This was the gap, and we filled that gap yesterday. So now where do we go? Well, probably can go back up into this range, this 185 to 187 range. We heard a handful of cattle, 150 head traded in the plains yesterday at that 185 area. That would be steady with a week ago. February still needs to go fill its gap, and feeder cattle had a really big day, over $4 gains. We're now premium over the index, which was in that 237 range. And I don't know how much more upside we can have here, but there's a lot of resistance, as you can see here. We'll extend this resistance out. This is a November front month contract, right in that range, 247.50, 45. That's going to be a big resistance for this market. The hogs also had a huge, huge day, a big upward move. We noted an outside reversal day. We didn't take out the lows. And when we couldn't do that, we took off and rallied here. Strong pork sales were a supportive feature as well. Not much other news overnight, so we'll let you go here. If you have any questions, reach out to us. Hope you have a great day of trade. I'll be on RFD TV this morning, 8:15 Central Time. Hope you have a chance to check that out. Thanks a lot.